Welcome back, children, once again to the third and the last session of the chapter Matter. Today we will discuss the different states of matter. They are solid, liquid, and gas. The state of matter depends on intermolecular force of attraction and intermolecular space. Greater the intermolecular force of attraction, lesser will be the intermolecular space among the particles. I hope you remember that intermolecular force of attraction is the attraction between the particles and intermolecular space is the space between the particles. Here you get a vivid picture of the arrangement of the particles in solid, liquid, and gas. These are few examples of solids: ice, bricks, wood, watch, diamond, and glass. In solids, the intermolecular force of attraction is maximum and the space between the particles is very, very less. Here you can see the microscopic picture of the particles of solid. You can see the particles, they move, they vibrate, but within their main position. They do not leave their main position. If we raise the temperature, the particles start vibrating more vigorously, but yet they will not leave their main position. Therefore, solids have fixed shape and volume. Next, here are a few examples of liquids: juices, water, oil, milk, soft drink, vinegar, etc. In liquids, the intermolecular force of attraction is less than solid and the space between the particles is more. Hence, liquids have definite volume but no definite shape. Here, children, you can see the microscopic picture of the particles of the liquid. These particles are moving. They are leaving their main position, but they move within the boundary of the vessel in which the liquid is kept. Here also, as we raise the temperature, the particles start moving more vigorously, and if we reduce the temperature, the particles will slow down. Now we take a few examples of gases: carbon dioxide, helium, steam, smog, oxygen, etc. Have you ever seen a beam of light entering a room? You will observe the dust particles moving in that beam of light. Movement of the dust particles signify the movement of gas particles. In this experiment, we will be discussing about the shape and volume of solid, liquid, and gas. Solids, example I have taken a Rubik's cube, a ball, and this bar of soap. All these three maintain their shape and volume. No matter I place it in any vessel, it will retain its shape and volume. This is because of very large intermolecular force of attraction in solids. In liquids, the intermolecular force of attraction is less than solids. Therefore, it does not have a fixed shape. I transfer the water into the jar. It takes the shape of the jar. I transfer it to the bowl. The water takes the shape of the bowl. When I transfer all the water into the glass, it takes the shape of the glass tumbler. Note, the volume does not change. In gases, the intermolecular force of attraction is negligible. If I spray the perfume, the gas that comes out, it occupies the entire space available in the room. This is because of large intermolecular space and negligible intermolecular force of attraction.
So we come to the conclusion that gases have neither fixed shape nor fixed volume. Thank you. Students, we have been talking about the presence of intermolecular space between the particles of matter. Logic says that if there is space between two particles, then the particles can be brought close or compressed by applying some force. Here, I have taken three syringes, each filled with sand, that is for solid, water for liquid, and air for gas. Now, I force the piston, keeping the other end of the syringe closed. We see that sand cannot be compressed. Let's see this water. I try to force water. It gets compressed to a little extent. But with air, if I've taken the air and I close this other end and I try to force the syringe, and I find that the air can be compressed to a large extent. So this means that in air there is large intermolecular spaces, and therefore the air can be compressed applying some force. In the second syringe, where I have taken water, the intermolecular space is less, so it can be compressed slightly. In the third syringe, where I have taken sand, that is solid, the intermolecular space is very, very less, and therefore we can say that the compressibility is negligible. It cannot be compressed. Here I have compared solid, liquid and gases in terms of intermolecular force of attraction and intermolecular space. Molecules in a solid are tightly packed and have little space to move, so they have fixed shape and do not flow. Whereas molecules in a liquid are less closely packed than solids and have more space to move, so they can flow and they don't have fixed shape. Molecules in gases are far from each other and move very freely, so they have neither fixed shape nor fixed volume. Properties like volume, rigidity, compressibility, ability to flow are a result of intermolecular space and intermolecular force of attraction. Finally, time to do the assignment. I will also be sending a copy of all the assignments on Snap Homework. As a help, I will also be sending the contents from the chapter that is given in your book on Snap Homework. This is all for now. See you soon in the next video when I will be taking up a new chapter. Thank you and bye-bye.